first thing you need to remember about the synapse, or the synapse, is that it's a join between two nerves. And it's about how nervous impulses are transmitted. In order to help you remember what's going on with nerves and where a join is, it's quite useful to remember the reflex arc, both in words and in diagrams. So I'll show you that now. So, reflex arc, you should remember stimulus, receptor, sensory nerve, relay nerve, motor nerve, effector. And if you were to draw that, it might look something like this. There's your receptor. Here's your sensory nerve with its cell body out on a branch. And there's the nucleus. Here's the receptor. So this coming in here is your stimulus. This is picked up by your receptor. The sensory nerve then joins with the relay nerve. And the relay nerve has the cell body in the middle, in line with the nerve fibre. And then finally, you have the motor nerve with the cell body close to the join between the two nerves, going down to these end plates here that are attached to the effector. Okay, which as always I'll tend to draw as a muscle. So that's the effector, that's the motor nerve, that's the relay nerve, that's the sensory nerve. And once the receptor picks up the stimulus, the electrical impulse is transmitted along this sequence of nerves to the effector. It doesn't involve the brain. Now, the synapse is the word used to describe these areas here, where the ends of two nerves join together. Now, if you remember, if the impulse is leading away from the cell body or towards the cell body, it's got different names. So can you see how this impulse goes here like this, and then this one goes along here like this. Now, if it's going away from the cell body, remember axon away, that's called the axon. If it's going towards the cell body, it's called the dendron. So you can see that at this junction here, it's the dendron of the relay nerve and the axon of the sensory nerve. If I draw this synapse in a bigger fashion, then you understand what's going on. So this is what the synapse is represented as. Okay, so this is that side there. So this is the axon of the sensory nerve. And then here is the other side. And this is the dendron of the relay nerve. Now, this is called a synaptic knob, and so is this. Okay, and this is called the synaptic gap. Okay, now in here the chemicals in the end of the axon called neurotransmitters, and these migrate to the surface of the synaptic knob when electrical impulse is sent along the nerve fibre. These vesicles, they're called, join with the membrane here and release the neurotransmitters into the synaptic gap. And then the neurotransmitters diffuse across the gap and land in these little areas here. Do you notice how they fit in? These here are called receptors. Once the neurotransmitter has crossed the gap and landed in the receptor, when the neurotransmitter lands in the receptor, it sets up a new electrical impulse in the dendron. So effectively, in a synapse, the message is electrical, chemical, and electrical. And it can only flow, the message can only go in one direction, because the neurotransmitters are made here and they have to be released here and cross the gap. It can't go the other way, because the neuroreceptors, the neurotransmitters are not made on this side. And that's basically how a synapse works. The real thing they want you to remember is that it's electrical, chemical, electrical. And these little things here are called, these chemicals here are called neurotransmitters. Okay? Now, the speed with which these cross the gap, or the speed at which a signal crosses a synapse, can be increased by using a stimulant, such as caffeine. And it can be slowed down by using a depressant, such as alcohol. And this is why alcohol affects our brain after we've been drinking, because it affects the speed with which neurotransmitters work. Now, you can use this to actually generate a revision sheet, okay? So you could fold this over, draw the diagram again, but this time, instead of writing the names on there, you can just draw them and label them with initials, and then the initials can prompt you to try and actually remember what's going on. So, for example, if you draw this, then this, then this, okay, you can call the whole thing an S. This side is a D, this side is an A, this is an NT, this is an R, this is a SG, okay, and then you remember E to C, H to E, okay, and then you should be able to remember that this is a synapse, that's the synaptic gap. It's a neurotransmitter, this is the axon, this is the dendron, and the message is electrical, chemical to electrical. And if you're not remembering it, you can flick back over to remind yourself what's going on. Quite much useful. Hopefully you understand how a synapse works.